This is the Geva BOS violin case. Let's open the box. My first impression is that this case feels really good quality. It is not easy to bend it, and that's what you really want from a case where you put something very valuable like your violin. It has two clips to open and close it. They are metal. And of course the handle to keep it in your hand. Good. What I don't like so much at the handle of this case is that it's fixed with rivets, and I have seen some cases where these rivets have been worn out and get out, and then or half or the whole handle falls off. I would like to see this made in another way. I know that Geva has also other systems for the handle, so my suggestion would be put another one anyway. And something that I immediately notice is that this bag is a little bit longer than the case, so the case doesn't stay on its side, which is something that a lot of musicians of course do, although it has three very small feet. Let me take this off. Ta-da! And this is what I would like to see also with this thing on it. This case comes in two variations. One has also this extra bag on top where you can put your books. We will come back to this later. The nice thing is that you can take it off. So if you are not planning to put your books inside, you can take it off. Then the case is a bit lighter even. But if you buy the case without this bag, you cannot find this bag separately, and also if you find it, you cannot put it on because that case doesn't have those four clips. Now there are three things that one wants from his case. First of all, your instrument has to fit, and you have to have enough space to put some of the things you carry on always, like your shoulder rest, your rosin, pencil, and maybe some other things. And the books, of course, if you choose for the case with the bag. You want it to protect your instrument if the case falls down when you are walking, on when you are walking a staircase or something like that. And of course, when you are outside, you want it to keep your instrument dry. And these are the three things that we are going to test. Test number one is to see how everything fits inside. There is one big compartment for your instrument with some extra space and a separate compartment. And here you find also the straps to put the case on your back and the key. This is the instrument that I will be using to test the case. As you see, it is already decorated, as it is going to be my crash test dummy. It is a playing violin. Here we go. The instrument fits well and it feels very steady, and the case has also this cushion at this side which will keep the instrument on its place. What I like is that the scroll doesn't touch the case, and that means that if the instrument with the case inside falls in this way, the neck won't break, which is a kind of damage that I see often when an instrument falls down. There is plenty of space to put your shoulder rest. You can easily put a wolf or a coon, but I think that also a bombusica would fit inside. In the compartment there is enough space to put your pencils, a set of strings, a tuner or a metronome, your rosin, and even a couple of snacks.
And here next to the scroll there is plenty of space to put your shoulder rest.
At the other side there is space for two bows. I have one. Fits perfectly. I would like to see that the bow is a bit more steady, because if you are running with a case on your back, the bow goes all over the place. The good thing is that this clip is flexible, because a lot of bows have been broken because someone pulled too far, but the clip allows that to happen and without breaking the bow. In the bag, of course, you want to put your books. There is plenty of space. I have even a thick notebook, which also fits easily. Let's put the straps on it. These are from plastic. They feel strong. It's okay. Okay, let's see if the instrument is still alive. Yes, it does, but the shoulder rest started to travel, and that's not what I want to see. The shoulder rest is free and there is a lot of space for it to go wherever it wants. The next test is the crash protection. So what is going to happen to your instrument if it goes down a staircase, for instance, like this one. But before we do the test, I want to say something. Don't try this at home. Don't put your own instrument in a case like that or whatever and throw it down the staircase. I know what I'm doing, and I'm using a very cheap instrument to do this. It would be very sad if you try something like this and your instrument is broken. Also, if the instrument that I'm using has no damage, that doesn't mean that your instrument also won't have any damage. It is one test, it might go well, but that doesn't give the guarantee that there won't happen anything to your instrument. Now let's find out what is going to happen. Looks like the only thing that happened is that the shoulder rest moved. The instrument is in perfect condition. The bow also, everything is okay. The final test that I'm going to do is the rain test. I'm going to simulate the rain, and I think 2.5 minutes are enough. It sounds short, but it's a long time. It's enough to go from the bus stop to your music school or to the concert hall or something like that. And I think that if you have to walk longer than 2.5 minutes in the rain, it should be better to cover the case with something else. Here we are with the case, soaking wet. In the meantime, it started raining because we are in Holland. Now, let's start with the upper side. There passed some water and my book is wet. Okay, so put your books in a plastic bag. And now, this is completely dry. This is completely dry. After a second exam, I noticed that there is water inside the case, unfortunately. Here, the lower part is wet. I was expecting the water to pass from the upper side. That's why I controlled there as at the beginning, but the underside is really wet. That's really a pity because I was very happy with this case. In the meantime, I had contact with Keva, and they told me that as the case is made from biomaterials, it was not possible to make it watertight. So you will have to decide on Orion if you think that it is a good purchase. You could spray it with some kind of seal to prevent water from going in, but then it won't be bio anymore. The price of the case is about 150 euro or dollars. So that makes it very interesting as it is very cheap for a lightweight case. It protects well your instrument, as we saw in the staircase, of course. So I cannot say that it's not a good purchase, but keep in mind the issue with water. Thank you very much for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to see more videos like this. Let me know if you have any suggestions about reviews you would like me to make, of course about both instrument products. And I will see you the next one. Bye bye.